And we are live! Hello, everybody! Why isn't the game showing up? Oh, come on! Oh, wait, duh. There we go! time to start the second game. I'm excited. Hell yeah. Oh. Oh, the connection's already starting off. Not great. That's good. Okay, it seems fine now. So long as it stays fine. Hell yeah.
Duck. I hear you, Blizzard.
No, Sly, I'm the wizard, and you're sitting duck.
I read you loud and clear, Lizard.
No, forget it, you're not taking this.
Yeah, I'm not. Look, Bentley, I know this is your first time out in the field, but you've gotta loosen up. If we're gonna get to those clockwork parts, I need you on your toes. So in plain talk, what's your status?
Well, I've established myself at the basement, and I'm pretty sure I can reach the service elevator if you can power it up from that security station.
Hang tough, pal. It might take some time, but I'll figure out a way to get up there.
Time to get going. Yay. Oh, I missed this game. I really loved this one. Yay!
Presto, all clear.
Thanks, pal. For your first time out, you did pretty well.
Oh, this operation is far from complete. Now that the lasers and spotlights are offline, Murray should be moving into position for your rendezvous. I'll stay here and provide computer support while you go on ahead.
Alright, don't need to tell me twice. What even is that holster on my side? Is that for a gun? Looks like that's what that's for.
According to my information, the clockwork parts are being stored up there. Now to get access, you're going to have to meet up with Murray at the rendezvous point. Unfortunately, the route through the garden is filled with guards.
No problem. I'll just take the long way around.
If memory serves, you need to jump and hit the circle button to run along ropes.
Yep. All right. Let's get it. Yeah. Frick off, birds!
Murray must have gotten lost along the way.
Oh, money. Money! Oh, hi, Murray.
Greetings, citizen. I hope you weren't harmed by my meteoropic entrance.
No, Murray. I kept at a safe distance.
Good, good. The thunderflop knows neither friend nor foe. only destruction.
Yeah, could you maybe channel some of that raw energy into the security gate?
Of course. It is nothing before the Murray.
Dude, I already went through.
Another barrier stands before you. Fear not, I shall bend it like the truth.
Solid work, Murray. You're really in the zone.
My hulking frame is too much for that puny rope. You go ahead and unlock the doors from the inside. I'll be waiting in the hallway to help you carry out the clockwork parts.
Christ. Yeah, no, he's literally the brawn.
I don't get it, Sly. The clockwork part should be here. This is all wrong. We need to pull the plug on this operation right now.
Oh, fuck.
Freeze, Cooper.
Inspector Fox.
Oh man, that's a different voice actor, alright.
Whereas you crooks are so predictable.
I never noticed it playing through these games as a kid.
Crime? I haven't stolen anything. Yet.
Oh really? Then who broke in last night and made off with all the clockwork parts? You've got the motive.
Bruh, why would he come back here if he already stole all the perks?
The method of entry and guard casualties all point to this being a claw gang job.
The claw gang?
Constable Neela, I allowed you to sit in on this stakeout as a favor to the Contessa. I really don't need any help. Oh, I think you might. Look at the facts. Facts? Sly Cooper is right here. I caught him red-handed. I'm just saying that there are other criminals in the world other than... Sly Cooper! After him! You can't run forever!
I can. Just watch me. Nope.
This wasn't part of the plan.
Yeah, well, this is where things get fun.
Freeze!
Can't catch me, bitch. You too slow. Stop jumping. Just start running.
It's getting a little hot. You guys go warm up the van. I'll keep Carmelita busy.
You're all going to jail.
Pick me up at the rendezvous.
Okay. Bitch. Nah, I'm not. You have shit aim, dude.
Hey, come back here, Ringtail.
No, I'm good. Bye.
Stop, thief.
No. Why don't I pick up some money on the way, though? That is like the. Whoa, whoa, whoa! That right there, though, is the ultimate insult. Just, like, grabbing money and shit while you're still running. Oh, our aim's getting better. Still can't touch me, though.
Hold still.
Bye! Fucking follow the van.
Carmelita's just as angry as ever. She's really quite lovely when she's angry. And that Constable Neela, was a reference to the Claw Gang just a slip of the tongue or an intentional clue? Either way, it's her only lead on the missing clockwork parts. Clockwork. He was consumed with jealousy for the Cooper clan's thieving reputation. Is it inappropriate to refer to him as a monster?
No.
No, not at all. What kind of person stays alive for hundreds of years with the express intention of wiping out a rival's family line? Imagine the hatred fueling that first decision to replace his mortal body with soulless machinery. Ultimately, it did the trick. Clockwork lived on. He caught up with my parents, and I wound up in an orphanage. It's there that I met my pals, Bentley, the brains of our outfit, and Murray, the brawn. They turned out to be all the family I needed. 2 years ago, I thought I'd finished it. How naive to think I could so easily put an end to that kind of hatred. And now he's back. In pieces, sure, but the threat is real. Does the Claw Gang even realize what they've stolen? I don't know what's in my future, but I won't let it be a repeat of my past.
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! Oh, fuck yeah. Time to go to Paris, boys!
I had to call in a few favors to get the goods on the Claw Gang's local operator. Dimitri, a sort of underworld celebrity, equally at home in high-class art circles and shady back-alley crimes. He was once a passionate young art student who worked hard to develop his own visionary style. Unfortunately, the art world wasn't quite ready for his kinetic aesthetic. So he gave them what they wanted and started forging old masterpieces. His way of punishing those with bad taste. Dimitri now runs a nightclub on the west side. The thumping
Hell
music,
yeah.
Colorful light shows, and a hint of danger lure in chic young patrons from far and wide. And it's here, hidden somewhere, where we'll find the clockwork tail feathers. What Dimitri plans to do with the clockwork part is beyond me. But those plans end tonight.
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
Nightclub.
I share in your enthusiasm, but before we hit the inside, we'll need to do a little reconnaissance work.
What do you have in mind?
I've installed this special antenna on the safe house to help with our first job, hacking into Dimitri's satellite array. The coordinates for the job start beacon have been uploaded to your binocular. Make your way to this position, and I'll give you a full briefing on our objective.
I'm on my way.
Let's fucking go. I know there's a way I can run.
If you click the L3 button, it'll press the left analog stick. I'll beam some virtual markers into your feedback.
There's how I run. Yay!
Sly, I need you to hack into Dimitri's communication array so that we'll have access to his database.
How am I supposed to do that?
To start, you'll need to get to the top of that tower. Then reposition the satellite dish to point at my safe house antenna. If you want to climb on stuff, jump and
Jump and press the circle button to climb pipes. I'm on it.
Oh, God. You saw nothing. Nope. Fucking go! Yeah! Bentley, you're getting real annoying with that. You're a fucking broken record. Stop it. I already figured that out. No shit.
Cellar.
Let's fucking go. Yeah. Let me in.
Good to see you, little buddy. I guess the way through the wine cellar is guarded by those rats. Bentley thought you might like some help clearing them out.
Sounds like fun. You and me, back to back?
Totally. Outnumbered, fighting impossible odds. It's perfect.
All right, pal. Let's get to it.
Fear the Murray!
Oh, God.
Hold on, Sly. Let me lower those bars for you. There you go. To get over this thing, you'll have to double jump. Hit the X button to jump. Then, while in the air, press it again to get some extra air time. Looks like you're on your own from here.
I'm used to it. Thanks for the help.
Anytime,
hell yeah.
Partner.
I already figured it out, dude.
Get near the table and press the circle button. These flashlight guards are too tough to fight head on. Crawl under the tables to sneak around him.
Oh. Well, never mind then. I thought I could beat the shit out of him afterwards. Let's go, I guess. Oh boy, there goes my dog. He screamed. Fuck. Let's get it.
Hit the circle button to crawl inside.
Bentley, I already fucking did it. Shut up.
In order to shut down those yellow lasers, you'll need to take out that guard. Sneak up behind him and press the triangle button to knock him into the air. Then the square button to slam and finish him off. Got that? The triangle button, then the square button.
Dude, I already did it. Fuck yeah.
If you get in a fight with those rats, the sneak attack won't work. It's purely a stealth move.
Give me all your money. Nice. Money.
Judging by the angle, it should lead to the printing press room. Jackpot! The heart of Dimitri's operation! Head for those windows and take some reconnaissance photos. Tap the R3 button, you know, click the right analog stick. Bring up your binoculars. It's already outfitted with a spy cam. Sly, use the right analog stick to zoom in and out on photo targets. Tap the R1 button to take a picture when you've got a good shot. Ingenious. Dimitri's using the clockwork tail feathers as printing plates. Given their rare alloy, they'll never wear out. Unlimited. The generator seems to be powering the security systems down here.
I totally won't blow this is inverted and I don't like it.
That's our target. Dimitri, professional lounge lizard and international fortune. That should do it, Sly. Head back to the safe house and we'll cook up a plan of attack.
Hell yeah.
The recon photos are a grim reminder of what the modern thief is up against. Spotlights, stepped up patrols. The sum of it all renders a direct assault impossible. To solve this puzzle, I'm going to need some more intelligence. First, replace this bugged painting with one Dimitri has in his office. Once in place, we should be able to listen in on his communications. Second, if you see the boss, tail him. We might learn something from studying his movements. Once we've got a proper understanding of the operation, those clockwork tail feathers are as good as ours.
Hell yeah. Let's fucking get it.
Clear from what?
Of that I'm uncertain. Ring the bell and follow him without being seen. Then maybe we'll find out what he's hiding.
Oh. I didn't know he just, like, kept talking during, like, the fucking part where we're tailing him. That's kind of funny. Yay, yay, yay!
Good job tailing him, Sly. He had no idea you were watching while he typed in that secret code. Hold on. Looks like that door leads to the nightclub's aqua pump. This might be useful for the heist.
Hell yeah. Time for the next heist.
This is a job for Murray. Come back to the safe house to switch characters.
Nah, me, I'm gonna go do my other mission. That's me!
Sneak into Dimitri's office and swap it with the original.
Nice. So we'll be able to listen in on his conversations.
Yes, I thought things might go more smoothly with an ear on the inside.
Bro, that's literally just fucking a picture of me.
Take any damage and the painting's ruined.
Bruh. Who the fuck are we gonna fool with this? Over that way. I went the completely wrong way. Thought maybe I could double back, but I most definitely can't. Yeah, go that way. Mm-hmm. Let's fucking go. Nightclub time.
The schematic indicates that door is locked from the inside.
That's all right. I never was one for the direct approach.
Well, because the indirect approach is way up there through that air vent.
Oh yeah, this theme goes hard, dude. It's fucking great. Safe.
Can't open this vault without finding all of the clues outside around the safe house.
Never knew I was here.
Avoid getting spotted by the flashlight guards. If you get caught, you can run away by holding down the R1 button.
Bentley, I swear to God, I will make turtle soup. Don't fucking test me. Oh, money. Fucking go! Oh, money.
Murray, I need you to make your way back to the aqua pump room and sabotage it.
Jeez, I don't supposed to get past these lasers?
You should be able to break that power box by throwing something at it. Press the circle button to use your stomp move near the ice machine to pick up a block of ice. Then press the square button to throw the block at the power box.
Hit the circle button to pick stuff up and the square button to throw. Got it.
Very straightforward. That's not... That actually worked?
You're strong, Murray. Try picking up other stuff in the room.
Yeah.
Enemies that are knocked out can be picked up with your stomp move. Throw something at that guard, then jump up there and pick them up with the circle button.
Money, 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 money. Putting on a whole new definition to sewer rats.
Okay, fellas, I've constructed a plan to get at the clockwork tail feathers, but we'll need to pull off a few more jobs to set things up for the heist. First, Sly will have to pick a few pockets in the theater so that we'll have access to the spotlight control center. Once that's accomplished, we'll be able to turn off all the security around the printing press. We'll need your muscle, Murray, to take out all the exterior alarm horns. We don't want anything to alert the guards while we pull off the big job. And finally, we'll need to get into the discotheque to drop this mirror ball. Trust me, it's all part of the plan.
All right, dude. I mean, not making any sense right now, but I trust you. All right, buddy. Let's start fucking chucking shit. I'm alive! I'm gonna take one of you with me. The next one over that way. Time to throw a newspaper at it. Oh, I can't run one. Yeah, never mind.
Heads up, if you leave this area, you'll abandon your current job.
What are you talking about, dude? I'm right almost by the horn. Fucking get to work. I don't know why there's no guards showing up, but all right. Guess I'll just fucking break the horn then, because there's no guards. And these newspapers are fucking thick. Sweet. Now it's all sly. Ooh.
Hold it, Cooper.
Constable Neela. Another policewoman hot on my tail.
Please, I led you here.
So that Claw Gang slip was a clue. Why are you helping me out?
I'm not as black and white as Carmelita. I know what a menace those clockwork parts are, and I don't want the likes of the Claw Gang putting them to use.
So what? It takes a thief to catch a thief?
Something like that. But if I'm going to trust you in this case, I need to know that you can keep up. Literally.
Literally?
Don't
oh boy.
Fall behind.
Fly, hold down the R1 button to run. You'll need it to keep up with Constable Neela.
The fuck? Where did... What? I don't even know where she went.
Fly, hold down the R1 button to run.
Bentley? Actually, shut up. Oh, she went that way.
Thank you.
Bitch, I can keep up with you.
Sly, we should work well together.
Glad you approve.
Now, legally, I can't enter Dimitri's nightclub without a warrant, but I happen to have obtained a key to his back door, which a person like yourself can use however he pleases.
Oh, we are absolutely going to work well together.
Oh, fuck yeah. Fuck yeah, dude. Bottles are a lot easier to find this time around. Like, they are much more out in the open than they were before. Where's my next mission? I can't see on the streets. Ah! Over there. Oh, up there. Not quite. I gotta get up onto the rooftops. Now we go.
Sorry, Bentley, but those fans are spinning way too fast to walk on.
They can be slowed down from this control panel, but you'll have to do a lot of pickpocketing to get at it. The guards are carrying special fragile keys that will be destroyed if you attack. Make sure you pickpocket their keys before you take those thugs out. To pickpocket guards, sneak up behind them and press the circle button.
That one. 3 out of like 6. More guards that way. Camera, please. You didn't see nothing. Go back to your guard duties. That's right, you didn't see nothing, you big dumb warthog. And now it's your turn to get gutted! Oh, right there. Duh.
Looks like the fans have stopped. Use them to get on top of the main chandelier and insert that splice clip.
Camera. For the love of God. That was a bit excessive, but all right.
No more security in the printing press room.
Lego. I'm gonna go get the other treasure that I saw in this area. There's also still a bunch of bottles here too. Oh God! No! Bye! You got shiny butt pockets? Oh, you do. Oh, fuck yeah. get shiny butt pockets. Shiny butt loot. Yeah.
To get past the laser fence, you'll need to blow it up. Press the triangle button to drop a bomb, and then get out of the way before it explodes.
Money.
Hey Bentley, how you holding up out there in the field?
Fine, I'm just fine. I just need to bob all the pillars supporting that disco ball and I can get out of here.
What's with taking out the disco ball?
Its impact will shake the nightclub's front peacock sign loose from its mooring. Look, I can't talk, now I've gotta keep moving, keep safe.
Poor buddy, he's doing his best. That was a close one. Dude literally almost got me. How do I get to the last one? Oh, duh, it's right there in front of my fucking face. I'm dumb. Yeah.
All Okay, fellas, the dominoes are all in place. Time to pull off the big heist. First, Murray will help me break into the old water tower. From there, I should be able to shut down the plaza fountain. Dimitri's sure to send someone out to get the repair truck. Sly, you'll pickpocket the truck keys off this guy once he shows up, then hand them off to me and Murray in the plaza. We'll go steal the truck while you climb to the top of the nightclub's peacock sign. When you're in position, Murray will fire the truck's winch line up to you and will use it to pull down the sign. If my calculations are correct, the impact should create an entrance to the printing press room. Then, Sly, you jump in, grab the clockwork tail feathers, and we all get the heck out of here.
I mean, we already have a way in, though. I could just sneak in when Dimitri's not around, and I can just take the tail feathers! Whatever.
Come on, chum! Let's get to that water tower! To my arms. I'll toss you up there.
Oh. I just... I just got up there, though. What? Murray, throw me, please. Okay, let me in. What is the... Fine, I'll fucking... I don't know why the throwing wasn't working.
I need to focus. Which valves do I turn to divert water pressure from the plaza? To change the flow of water through a valve, I should press the circle button.
Okay, okay. That's not gonna do anything. I need to do this one. I'm doing something here.
Success!
I did it? Question mark?
Sly, the water pressure to the fountain should be disabled.
It's off all right. They're already sending out the repair guy to fix it up.
I'll take that. Thank you. Got the key.
Okay, head back to the fountain to make the exchange.
It's all you.
Let's head out for the repair truck.
Fucking go! Oh, Murray beat him up. Okay. Never mind, I was gonna sleep dart him and then blow him up.
I'll take the wheel. I know how to drive a stick ship.
Thanks, Murray.
I need to get in position on top of the nightclub's peacock sign for phase three. I'm in position.
Great. We're just driving up right now. Get ready to grab the tow harpoon. Whoops.
Hooks on. Pull away.
Now fuck you! Fuck off my truck! Fuck. My sneezes fucked me up.
I'm in position.
Great. We're just driving up right now. Get ready to grab the tow harpoon.
Hooks on. Pull away.
Yeah.
Behold the majesty of gravity and inertia.
That was real subtle, Bentley.
Okay, you jump in, grab the clockwork tail feathers, and we're out of here.
Let's get it, bitch.
Deal what you're playing with. It'll bring more than your house down.
Look, bro, I see you are a top cowboy. A man with taste, style, vision, a connoisseur of finer things. Like me. Look, I'm sure the two cats in a bag like us can work something out. Yeah? We smooth. Look, smooth the money. You like the money.
All you want. I can. No deal. You and the rest of the claw gang have to be stopped. Clockwork will never again see the light of day. Just hand over the tail feathers and we can...
What is this with clocks, bro? Vision. Are you hearing what I beam to you? You think you have juice? Don't show me a little mind when talking about such big things. You think you can swing the bat? Show your bling and let me shine you.
I have no idea what you're saying. And your suit sucks.
No! Oh, I fucking love the dialogue in this game. Ah! What the fuck?
My suit is greasy sweet.
Oh, that thing is like laser focused.
Yeah!
Oh, that's gotta fuck him up bad.
You take clockwork feathers and my counterfeit in operation. It's past tense.
I'm doing you a favor. What kind of thief prints money? There's no honor in that.
You... Crackerbox!
Yay! Yay!
My gang and I had done it. The clockwork tail feathers were ours, and Dimitri's counterfeiting operation was ruined. Due to the untimely arrival of Carmelita, my escape got a little tricky. Angry at having just missed me, she took it out on Dimitri, shutting down the nightclub and throwing the frustrated forger behind bars. The gang and I headed out of town for a week in Monaco. I figured the team had earned themselves a well-deserved break.
Oh, yes. My favorite episode from this game, actually. I fucking love the aesthetic of this. Just, this whole area that we're about to go in is really nice, and I love it.
Another clockwork part had surfaced in India, so the boys and I loaded up the van and zeroed in on our next target. A mysterious spice lord known as Rajan.
A self-made
Rajan's
man
a fucking badass. I love him.
Of Calcutta, he started his life of crime selling illegal spices in the black market, eventually growing his small outfit to a sizable operation, and earning himself a seat in the prestigious Claw Gang. He's since crowned himself Lord of the Hills, and while he goes to great lengths to convince others of his royalty, it's mostly to convince himself. True to form, he's holding a lavish ball in his newly purchased ancestral palace. The reason? To show off his latest acquisition, the clockwork wings. The symbol of my enemy. If you saw the wings silhouetted against the night sky, it was already too late for you. Especially if your name was Cooper. Rajan believes displaying the wings will bring him prestige. And maybe they will. But they're also bringing me.
Yeah. I'm excited. Let's fucking go. Oh, would you look at that? It's delicious treasure. Oh, I have to run it back to the safe house in time. That shouldn't be a problem. Did it! Oh, well, fuck.
I forget one of the Cooper family's greatest thief moves? Whenever I'm near pointed objects, I just need to jump and hit the circle button to perform a ninja spire landing.
That's correct. Now let's see it in action.
Hey. These guys doubt my skills. Ooh, bottle.
There seem to be plenty of branches for me to walk on. I'll figure it out.
It's as easy as 1, 2, 3, bitch. Eh. Yeah. Yeah. And I'm in. Oh!
Easy does it, Sly. Just don't go out onto that balcony and you should remain undetected. Looks like the wings have been welded onto that statue.
Wait, what? Go back in. Wait. Oh, over there.
Jean Bisson, a member of the Claw Gang and Canadian shipping baron. He owns half the trains in Canada.
Fucking...
Another Claw Gang member...
Where are the other guests? Is that it? No, it's not. Ah!
Carmelita's here too! She must be undercover with the Contessa to help bust Rajan!
Damn, Neela!
Another officer undercover. Watch yourself, Sly. This party is crawling with cops. That's all the photos I need. Bring them back to the safe house, and we'll start building a game plan.
Yay!
Clockwork wings in the middle of a crowded ballroom is going to take some serious misdirection. And the squad of undercover cops only makes things more complicated. Although, we might be able to use them to our advantage. But no matter what we do in the ballroom, sooner or later we'll need to deal with Rajan's security chopper. Murray can take it out with some of the local armaments. But he won't be able to get inside the palace until Sly lowers the drawbridge for him.
Let's fucking get it then.
To, pal, but the winch is all locked down. You know where I can find the keys?
Key guards have recently taken up positions around the palace. Sneak in, pick all of their pockets, and bring the keys back to the lockdown winch.
Let's go fucking get some keys. Give me your shit. Your fucking gate. Oh, oh. Fucking go! She's just crying because why not? Ah, shit.
For the dance.
Huh? Sorry, sir, but we have a dress code. You got a tuxedo?
No.
Sorry, pal. No tux, no entry.
Bruh.
Sorry, Sly. Somehow I totally overlooked the need for formal wear. Well, that guy's not going to let you in without a tuxedo.
Don't beat yourself up, Bentley. At a party this ritzy, there has to be a spare penguin suit around here somewhere.
Try the guest house. Someone may have overpacked.
Hell yeah. Now I have cat in lap.
I'm in position inside the guest house.
Hi, Booby.
Well, I recommend searching all the rooms. It's statistically probable that each should hold at least one portion of a tuxedo.
What do I look for inside the rooms?
This isn't an exact science. Ransack the place until you find part of a tuxedo.
Any plan which involves ransacking is okay with me.
Oh, jeez, I was sneezing all day. I've been sneezing all day.
Attention guards, this is Lord Rajah. The party here is in full swing and all visitors are now in the ballroom. Now, wait, this ballroom on the up and up. Not all of the guests are. So be on careful lookout for problems. I don't want any bad press from this event.
Booby, just come here. Stop, like, leaving my lap. Just lay your butt down and just chill out. You big fucking weirdo. Cap. Boosh. Ruby, just chill out. What? Being such a butt. Hi, Ruby. What's up? Yep, that's right. I was never here, you fucking dumbass.
You might need to use your stealth attack in here. Remember, the triangle button knocks guys up into the air, and the square button brings them down hard.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Roll down and stay down. What? Come here. Come here. Stop being a butt. You... Dude. You've been chewing your butt again. You got scabs all over your butt. I don't like you chewing your butt. Just lay down and chill out. No. Lay down and chill out. Hang on. Why are you being such a butt? What? What's wrong? What? You are not crying about being fed. You have a little under an hour before you get fed. I don't want to hear that shit. Come here. I'm not gonna have you scream at me. Go outside. Okay, back. Oh, come on. Oh. Ooh, better pen. Oh no, you've got something valuable in your pockets. Take it. Yeah. Give me your valuables. Oh god. Fuck.
You've been through here.
Shut up, Bentley.
Try another room.
Bentley? Shut up. I want your valuables, please and thank you.
This is Rajan's room. Stay sharp. He's probably got extra security.
Oh god, they're all trying to get me. Oh, shoes. Snake. Give me your, I said, give me your valuables. Thank you. Yeah! Hon, I'm right here. Okay, there's nothing else in this room, I don't think. The health is nice, though. Give me money! Where the fuck do you want me to go, Bentley? I almost fell right off. Dude, where do you want me to go then? I don't think there's anywhere else to go. Unless Rajong's room somehow still has another piece.
You've already got the piece from in here.
Then fucking where?
A touch part was already found in here.
Did I miss a room somehow? I did. I'm blind as shit! Don't look at me! I got the gloves!
That's it! Now that you've got a complete tuxedo, the doorbell will let you into the ballroom.
Aced it. Totally didn't fuck up. Got it. And he lost sight of me. Okay. I'll take that. And I'm gonna... beat the shit out of you! Let's fucking get out of here. Okay. Let's get it, big guy.
That chopper is a menace to all future aerial operations while on this job.
Yeah, it's all covered in missiles and guns and stuff.
Now be a team player and take it out with that rusty pre-war turret.
Okay, I had a potato gun once. I'll bet it works just the same.
All right.
Hit buttons fast to keep your strength up. Hit buttons fast to keep your strength up.
Hard to do that, dude. Especially when there's a cat where she's not supposed to be. Oh god, so many missiles. Whoa, that one's fucking wily. Whoa, 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 these aren't fair. Stop. Stop. Stop! Stop! Frick you! Looks like it. You're getting all huffy and impatient. Do I have to kick you out too? Or will you calm down if I hold you? Will you calm down if I hold you? Yeah? Oh yeah, she likes this. See, look, I even turned off the fan because I know you hate it. Even though I need it, I turn it off because I know you hate it. You feel better now? Being held, the fan got turned off. You good? You done being brat? There. See, that's not so bad. There you go. Fine. Oh, gee. Stab it! Stab it! Oh, God. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. crap. Okay, for a minute and already gets super hot. I'm sorry, hon, I need to turn it back on. It's hot. Oh boy, it's time for one of my favorite missions.
Your tuxedo now, sir?
Of course I do. I'm here to dance.
Then come on in.
Hell yeah.
Your tuxedo disguise is working perfectly. No one will recognize you in that outfit.
Maybe if you took off the mask, it would also help.
Just the girl for the job. Constable Neela, you look lovely this evening.
I'm sorry. Do I know you?
I used to chase after you back in Paris.
Paris? Sly Cooper? You aren't by any chance here to turn yourself in. Old Ironsides would fall out of her dress.
As good as that is, how about a dance first?
Enchanté.
Alright, let's get it. This is a much better rhythm thing than fucking
try to memorize the steps.
Other bitch.
Now your turn.
Yes, I am. Do you mind?
Not at all.
That fellow is very graceful.
If only you moved spice shipments as well.
Silence.
This is so much better.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was delightful.
Thank you, Constable Neela. After all, it takes two to tango.
Yes, and three is always a crowd.
Hang on.
Your friend here
Hun.
Is quite an accomplished dancer.
Get
I tried to make him look good. Please, Neela. His skills far surpass you.
Perhaps
Damn.
Later dance, Miss...
Miss Fox. Carmelita Fox. And I accept.
Boys, we're ready for the next phase. I plan to get at the clockwork wings requires the use of the electric winch above the ballroom. To get control over the device, I'll need to hack the computers in Rajan's boardroom. Plus, we'll need an extra strong saw blade to cut the wings off the statue. To make a saw blade that durable, I'll need Sly to steal the gems off the headdresses on Rajan's prize elephants. And finally, I'll take to the field with my remote control helicopter and nullify the palace's surface-to-air defenses. That should clear things up for the heist.
All right, then. We'll be back in just a moment. I'm gonna go feed my pets, because I don't want to deal with them screaming. Hello, Hun.
Alright, we are back. Where's the game? Oh no. Okay, there we go. We're right there for a second.
Bentley, that door looks pretty heavy. Maybe I can crawl on that hole under the steps and find an alternate route.
Let's fucking go. Rats.
Sure looks spooked.
A job well done, Sly. Now comes the hard part. I need you to snatch the headdress jewels worn by both elephants. The jewels are firmly embedded, so keep whacking at them with your cane to knock one loose.
I'll need to make use of the rooftops to get to one of the elephants' backs, but it shouldn't be a problem.
Oh God. This elephant is upsetting spaghetti.
Where the fuck am I?
Thanks for bumping me up to the top, elephant. Shit, I missed my shot. Come here, buddy. Hey, buddy, come here. I need your last headdress, dude. Thank you! Oh. I need to go do the Bentley one next. Oh, shit! Well, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, shit. This fucking happened like 40 minutes ago, but, Yell, you sit? I don't know how to fuck. You know what? Hang on, wait. I'll just do this. Thank you for the follow. My throat is fucking dry, dude. I'm supposed to get up there, dude. Oh. This is how.
Bentley, what's your status?
I'm in position with the RC chopper. All systems are go to neutralize their surface-to-air defenses. We're going to need free reign of the sky during the heist.
Well, be careful. Chopper parts aren't cheap.
Hostile has been sighted.
Hey, Bentley. Left analog stick to steer the chopper and hit the X button to drop bombs. If you lose track of the Jeep, I'll project a holographic targeting arrow. Follow it back into the action.
Let's get it. Go. You can't touch me, bitch.
Nice flying, partner. That Jeep's out of commission and we'll have clear skies for the heist.
Boopula. Are you done eating? Do you want to go out, mister? Does my boobie want to go out? Oh, my throat's awful today. I hope I'm not getting the fucking thing. I doubt I am. I haven't left the house in months. But still. Bottle? No, I'm running bottle!
So you want me to crawl under each till I find it?
That's the idea.
Don't see any code.
Try another table. It's here somewhere.
I want your valuables.
Table doesn't have the code. No code here.
It's always the last one you check.
This is it.
Fantastic. Now, type the code into the vault's laser door entrance.
I'm not gonna remember all of that, but I don't think it's gonna make me remember, but I'm gonna look anyway. So 4, 6, 5, 8, 3, 2, 1, 1. Oh fuck, that was a bad time to come out.
Now type the code into the vault's laser door entrance.
I got a bit of a problem to deal with right now. Okay, I didn't have to remember the code, thank God.
Nice work! Make your way to the security lockdown switch and let it be in Murray.
First, I want all this money.
Breaking us in, pal. The Murray approves.
Let's get down to brass tacks. I need to hack both the ballroom computers to get control of the electronic winch above the ballroom.
So what are me and Sly here for?
The second I enter their servers, they'll be on to us. You guys need to work together to keep the thugs off my back.
You and me, pal, side by side.
The Murray knows no fear.
Let's get it.
Okay, I'm in. Hacking the level 6 barrier. Almost there. Got it. Moving on to the level 5.
Oh fuck, Mark! Oh fuck! I didn't know Bentley was over here now. Shit.
Okay, I'm close. Changing back for level 4 access.
Oh. Fucking try me, bitch. I'm gonna beat you, beat your ass. Fuck you. Yay, yay, yay.
Almost got it. Okay, going for level 3.
Oh, fuck. No.
I'm so close. Yes. Headed for level 2.
I almost punched Sly. Oh no. Theoretically, couldn't we have just, like, barricaded the doors and kept them from, like, barging in?
Almost! Almost had it! Going for level 1 access!
No problem. Me and the big guy had it covered.
Hurry, let's hook up the direct feed and get out of here while the coast is clear.
Time for the fucking heist.
Okay, synchronize your watches. This heist is going to take extreme precision. Here's the plan. I'll start things off by demolishing the palace's main bridge. That should cut off reinforcements from the guest house and hopefully distract the ballroom guard standing watch over the clockwork wings. Sly will then take Carmelita up on her offer for a dance, and while the crowd is transfixed by their tango, Murray will lower into the ballroom on the electronic winch. Once down, he'll cut the wings free and then winch back up for an exit. Murray should then make his way out of the palace. I'll cover his exit with the RC chopper. Once he's past the drawbridge, we're home free.
Let's fucking go. For sure he would see me.
Okay, Bentley. Murray and I are moving into position. You still think you can demolish something that large?
It doesn't take an engineer to figure out how to blow up a bridge. I'll start by placing charges on all of the lower cleats. Once the structure destabilizes, those retainer rings on the upper cleats should pop right off. That should enable me to bomb all of the upper cleats, which will bring it all crashing down.
Just watch your head when that thing gets unstable. We need that brain of yours in one piece.
Hell yeah. Oh, fuck.
Okay.
Let's fucking go. Time for the rhythm section.
It's destroyed. Take all the manpower you need and look into it.
Murray, you in position?
Check.
It looks like Bentley's little distraction did the trick. Initiate phase two. I'll take care of Carmelita and the crowd. You handle the heavy lifting.
Let's get it.
Miss Fox, I believe you owe me a dance.
About time. I thought you had left.
Just waiting for the perfect moment.
Let's fucking go.
Enforcement.
I often deal with police while on the job.
Hell yeah.
Tell me, stranger, what's your name?
Why ruin the moment?
Huh? I don't understand.
The wings! What happened to the clockwork wings?
What? How? Who could have... What? Cooper!
Yeah, see, as you can see, that rhythm segment was much, much better than the rhythm segment that Miss Ruby had to do. You going for the exit, Murray?
Nice flying, Bentley.
It would be even nicer if you went straight for the exit like you're supposed to. Would have been even shorter if you just went the normal way. But, you know, who am I to judge? Oh, God.
We're almost home free!
We would have been more home free if you didn't take a stupid route! Fucking go. But we're not done with Rajong just yet.
After the gang and I got away with the clockwork wings, Carmelita blew her cover and started making arrests left and right. With his reputation in shambles, Rajong was forced to flee from his own party. He's now in hiding, somewhere deep in the jungle. The gang and I took a break and headed for Bollywood. It took some doing, but we eventually snuck Murray onto the set of a full-blown Indian musical. I was happy the guys got to unwind, but Rajong was still out there. And somehow, I knew things were about to get tough.
Oh boy. It's time for episode 3. Oh boy! I fucking love this episode. Like, all of Rajong's segments are like my absolute favorite part of the game. Because he is my favorite Sly Cooper villain.
Somehow. He'd managed to transform a long-forgotten temple into the thriving center of his spice operation. And it's there where we'll find him. The jungle, too thick to drive through, forced us to walk the long distance to our target. We ran into a few problems along the way, but pushed on. For the temple was more than just Rajan's hideout. It was also home to the Clockwork Heart. A pump so strong and tireless, it could increase spice production tenfold. Good for Rajong, but awful for the rest of the world. Hope he's not counting on that heart too much, because tonight, it comes home with me.
Oh boy. Wait, hang on, wait. Before that, I need to sell all of my treasure. Money! Wait a minute. Look at Sly's eyes! I hate that! That is grade A nightmare fuel. All right then. Sly, please never do that again. Perfect lint. Wait, oh, that way. You've got a shiny in your pocket. Give it to Mirror! Thank you!
Nice work, Bentley. I'll take a hidden passage over the front door any day.
Oh.
Let's go!
For the top.
Thank you for the pin. Where do I go from here? I think I was supposed to go up there, actually. I think that's just for, like, if I fall down there. Oh, yeah, I was supposed to go up here. Thank you for the hill.
Some of the vines around here are really slippery. Jump and hit the circle button to go for a ride.
Lego! Yup. Oh boy.
Desert is under some steep security. Heck, Rajan is carrying half of it at all times. Forget it, the goods, I'll need to gather some more information. Sly will plant a bug in Rajan's office, while I lift the spice operation blueprints off the Spice Lord while he makes his rounds. Unfortunately, while we're collecting intelligence on him, he'll be collecting data on us with an elephant-driven satellite array. Take it out, or he'll be able to intercept all of our communications.
Oh boy. Sounds like that's the thing we need to do first, is to take that out. Which means... that one.
Rajan is able to monitor all of our communications out here with that elephant-driven satellite array.
That's pretty grim. You got a plan for shutting it down?
Don't I always? Now, the local spice plants are illegal for good reason. Eat too many, and you'll go into a fit of uncontrolled rage.
Keep that stuff away from Murray. Oh, wait, I get it. I put some spice plants in the elephant's feed bag. He chows down, gets all crazy, and then presto, the satellite's in pieces.
A crude interpretation of the plan, but accurate. The trick here is harvesting the spice plants. You'll have to do some serious climbing, as they only grow high up in the jungle canopy.
I can manage. Fucking war. Time to get some spice plants. Oh no, it's absolutely just meth. Like, we're not even gonna say it's not. It's straight up meth. What the fuck was that? Gotta climb all over again. No hiccups. Ooh, hiccups. Let's go. This thing is extremely unstable. The fact that it's just rocking is like, huh? Oh, valuables, what do you say? Thank you. Yoink. God, seeing Sly's face from the front isn't great either. I don't like the way they did his eyes, because it's very uncomfortable. What the fuck is that?
This dude's just stuck. This was a mistake! Aha, there's my way up. Oh, I need to get to those vines. If the camera could not, that would be wonderful. Ooh, 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 ooh. See that one. Where's the last one? I don't know where it is. Where the hell is it? I think it might be over this way. Where is the, oh! Yeah, it is this way. Valuables. Don't mind if I do. Gimme. You cheap bitch. That gave my controller quite the rumbly. Nope, that's not happening. I think I need to take a different approach. That man blind and deaf. Ooh, that tree. Aha. Here we go.
Sayonara, satellite array.
Oh boy. I mean, it's not really destroyed. You just got rid of the elephant. They can get another elephant! It's not like that was their only elephant. Unless it was, which in that case, that's hilarious.
Let me get this straight. We're gonna bug Rajan's office with a bug?
It is an elegant plan, I agree. Now pay attention. That water bug can only survive in stagnant pools. If kept out of water too long, it'll become unhappy and likely draw the attention of local guards.
Looks like there's a few pools along the way to Rajan's office. A short swim every now and then should keep our little friend quiet.
Thank you.
where's the next? No, you don't. Shit. Oh shit. I lost the book. So I cannot get hit while I'm carrying it or I will lose it. And I gotta start over. I'll deal with these guys while the water bug sits in the pool. Clear. It's fucking skedaddle. To deal with some monkeys. Oh god, no. The monkeys can get me up here, but the guards can't. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. Pocket this dude. Thank you. Boink. Boink. All right, let's go, little buddy. Where's the next? Oh, right here. Sweet. Where's the next pool? It. Damn it. I didn't know where the next pool was. Probably should have looked around before I just ran off with the bug. Picking pockets, picking pockets, picking pockets. Shit. Fuck. Get in the pool. Oh no, not that. Ooh, boy. And they'll pick some buckets. Oh, the other pool's right there. I just need to get up there. Like that. I don't think that's how you're supposed to get up there, but I don't care. Oh. I was in the room, and I lost the bug. You know, I know you're supposed to take this long route, but I'm gonna try shortcutting the shit out of this. All right, little bug. We're going a different way. Thank you. They have no idea where I went. They thought they killed me. Now time to pickpocket all these bitches. One and a two, one and a three, thank you! Yoink! Oh wow, even the guard left. Sweet! Let's go! And this time, let's not lose the bug. Yoink.
I've already tuned in to the bug's wing vibrations. I'm a genius.
Yay. Let's just fuck up Rajang's office. Let him know I was here. Give me valuables. Thank ya. But I think that's where we're gonna end it off for now. Yeah, there we go. I squid. But I will see you all next time. Bye bye.